Parental discretion is advised.
This show is brought to you by Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. SliceOnBroadway.com, IndieWrestling.us. Check out IWC, RWA, and more. And listeners like you, support this show at Patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. Wrestling Mayhem Show, 562 days we've been getting together to talk about wrestling of a professional nature. I'm Mike Sorg, at Sorgatron on the Twitter, live from Mayhem Studio here in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the Steel City. And I got a hell of a crew, a regular crew, a little bit of a return as well. And we're going to have a lot of fun here tonight. You could say that this show could be on fire. With me out of Poughkeepsie, New York, he is the Rock and Roll Express, Mad Mike.
This shit gonna be lit, Sorg!
I apologize for bursting everyone's eardrum.
That's all right. I think I've muted you enough. How you doing, Mike? I know
my voice is being silenced.
I adjusted your volume a little bit. I see you have a lot more energy than the Raw wrap up last night.
That's making a SmackDown most fucking lit, Sorg.
Fantastic.
Was actually really good, y'all.
And also with us, he is back. It's been a good while, but back on the Wrestling Mayhem Show, he's Tonio Garza, WrestlingRevolution.com, back on the OG Patreoner as well. Thank you for joining us.
It's been so long. Finally,
it's been
back.
I
know.
Sorry, I couldn't help it.
That's non-canon.
Well, we're gonna catch up with you and everything else going on in the wrestling world in the next however long, including Mayhem Mania with Matt Carlin's later in the show, so please stick around for that. In the meantime, please check us out at WrestlingMayhemShow.com. You can subscribe to us over there on iTunes, Stitcher, Spreaker, iHeartRadio, video versions on the YouTube and the Facebook pages, live stream here on the Facebook page as we're doing here on Tuesday night with our good buddies Wheels, Brandon, Tina out in Seattle, and Billy. Just saw Billy Johnson at the IWC show this weekend. What is up? Mainstream Matt is making sure that we stay under control here in the meantime as well. Enjoy us at live.wrestlingmayhemshow.com. No matter what technology we might be using, it will be linked over there, and you can join us in case Facebook Live decides that we are too hot for this shit. You can also check us out thanks to our friends over at the405media.com, streaming over there 9 p.m. Pacific time. Which none of us are on the West Coast, so that doesn't help us. But so for you guys out there, 9 p.m. Pacific time, 7 days a week currently, you can catch the latest episode of the Wrestling Mayhem Show. So thank you so much to them for supporting us and getting us out there on their network. You can also drop us a line at 412-206-WMS0. It's 9670. Let us know your thoughts on wrestling for the week, or just call us when you're drunk. That's kind of fun. Go take that, put it in your contacts, and put it under the label thing to dial when I'm drunk, and then put an A in front of that, and then put it on your favorites, and then
you know what, Sorg, just say it as your emergency contact.
Yes.
Just set the Mayhem Show line as your emergency contact.
Maybe not your primary one, because we want you to.
No,
you
know, the primary one, Sorg.
Should I make a legal statement here? Maybe. Because you're as close to legal advice as I can get.
Do not express the views and conditions set forth by the Wrestling Mayhem Show.
There you go. That's it. Thank you. Thank you very much. But probably the safer way to contact us is goodtimes@wrestlingmayhemshow.com. Don't email us. Oh, thank you. Yes. Maybe not email us when you're drunk, because I don't know if we'll be able to read it.
Through that sort.
I forgot. No, you know what? I forgot.
Use text to speech. And then email us.
Ooh, that could be fun. I feel like some old emailers might have used to do that. And of course, definitely drunk tweet us at Mayhem Show on the Twitter. Also, a big thanks to our Patreon supporters, patreon.com/WrestlingMayhemShow. Thanks to our good friends, Bo Diggity! Woo! Ed Burke, the Matthew and Jennifer Carlin's Foundation for Podcast Betterment, Tragar, and Bobby F. J-Town at the $1 fan of the show level, and at the $5 Pocky Club. Thank you so much, Tina and Christopher out there as well. Again, you can support the show at patreon.com/wrestlingmayhemshow. A lot of different ways for you to do that. The $5 level gets Mayhem Gold and State of the Mayhem, which, hey, is the end of the month. We need to do one of those soon. I point at my producer for reminding me later. So
I'm sure it will be huge.
Huge news. Huge. Actually, the big news is on AwesomeCast this month, I think. But
and also, if you want, after we have the State of the Mayhem, I will fact check the State of the Mayhem.
Yo, this is a good idea. This is a great idea. Fact check. Excuse me. Fact check. I'm going too fast. I'm going too fast, man. But anyways, let's get into the show. First of all, holy shit, there's a pay-per-view this weekend.
Yet another one.
We're at that stage. Welcome to our existence for the next forever in WWE as we do this podcast. But anyways, oh, wow, I'm sorry. I put up WWE.com and the picture of Randy Orton doing the pose in front of the burning Wyatt Camp compound. It is my new wallpaper. Anyways. Yeah, there's Dudders in the studio. You just yelling. but Fastlane, the pay-per-view, holy crap, Matt Carney just scared the shit out of me. I just looked up at the door and there's a Matt Carney standing there. Anyways, this is literally the pay-per-view, like, year to year that I care the least about. I'm going to just put that out there. I think we got some interesting stuff considering.
Do we? I know that's my gimmick, but do we? We just have a lot of depressing shit on that pay-per-view.
Okay, maybe a little bit. Wait, okay. Let me hear, because if you hit the raw wrap-up, you've been getting Mike's opinion here. Garza, tell me what on this show you're excited about. Damn it. I thought we were going to have a super positive show.
How about Samoa Joe versus Sami Zayn? That I'm actually excited about.
Yeah?
I'll give you that. I'm excited for the wrestling.
I'm excited for in-ring action.
I'm excited for the grapple fights.
I'm excited.
Actually, no. Neville versus Jack Gallagher should be really good.
No, definitely. Definitely.
That I'm excited about. Samoa Joe versus Sami Zayn is going to be good. The rest of the pay-per-view could honestly not happen, and I'd be much better with that.
Okay. What about you, Garza, on the rest of the show?
It's just a pay-per-view that I'm trying to get into WrestleMania, but I can't because there's Fastlane, you know? So it's like getting in between my excitement right now. I do know that there are a bunch of matches with really big stakes, so I think I'm more interested to see like the outcomes.
Yeah,
I guess at this point, just to like fully understand what's gonna happen at WrestleMania. But yeah, like there's some matchups I just feel like we shouldn't be seeing them right now. We should wait for them for WrestleMania.
Mm-hmm. I can see that. You know, of course, we have probably the biggest of those is what's gonna happen with the Universal title, right? And the groans.
No, that's not groaning. That's me crying.
Okay.
Because this is just CM Punk versus The Rock all over again.
I'm afraid it might be. I really am afraid it might be.
It absolutely categorically is. And the worst part is, Kevin Owens is going to be so pissed, he's going to make Chris Jericho lose the U.S. title before WrestleMania 2. So that's not going to have any title at all.
Wait a minute, Chris Jericho's still a U.S. title holder.
Yeah, of course he is.
I completely forgot about that.
I know, because they don't care about it. They don't care about shit, Sorg.
We have 3 hours of Raw, and I didn't realize a title was missing. That's amazing. Mm-hmm. That's amazing.
Hey, and our company has a title missing, too. We'll talk about that later.
TNA. Oh. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, they do.
Uh-huh.
We have... Hold on, I think I might be set up for him to, if he wants to... Do you want to join in the show now, sir? Are you good? I mean, you're pretty much good.
Yeah, you're
good. We might have an audience member hanging out in your camera shot.
I hear we're looking for a little bit of positivity, the power of positivity on your show.
Yeah, a little bit.
Do I need to point out that before Chris Jericho held the United States title, that Roman Reigns was hauling it around. So, I mean, hey, yeah, you know they did care about it. So,
yeah.
I'd rather see Roman Reigns versus Braun Strowman for the U.S. title and Braun Strowman get that belt at Fastlane.
Look, Jericho has to sell his injuries. So that's why he's not around.
Yeah, that's why you definitely don't see him posting that he's at all the house shows in Germany. You definitely don't see that.
I don't see it. I don't see anything. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, this is the way
he's got to get around. I mean, he's got to get on that Fozzy liner. You know what I mean? I mean, it just happens that they're booked in all the same places as house shows. You know, he just likes to show up places like
he's in the rings or getting attacked by Kevin Owens.
that's true too.
All right, I do need to point out that Jen Carlins is pointing out in the chat room. Dean Ambrose is the longest reigning.
This in is her true. Heart. Yes.
Sorry, Matt.
Also true. Also true. Yes. I can't imagine we go this show without seeing Chris Jericho.
Oh,
actually, I can.
No, really? I can too. I can too. I don't see it.
I'm actually expecting Goldberg to win like in 1 minute. And then while Owens is bitching on Monday, that's when Jericho comes back.
And kind of an I told you so kind of mode.
Well,
yeah, something. Because I find it hard to believe that Owens and Goldberg are going to go longer than Goldberg and Lesnar.
So are we making that official bet where we bet how long the Owens Goldberg match is going?
Wait. Actually, Matt has been working.
I was just about to chime in when Garza was talking about it. I was like, Garza, do you want to enter the Fastlane, the Mayhem Mania Fastlane Challenge and predict the bell-to-bell total time of Owens Goldberg? Closest without going over, we get to hand out a free dose of punishment, no questions asked, in the following Tuesday's round of Mayhem Mania. Do you want to pick a time right here, right now, or do you want to think about it till the end of the show?
I can leave. No, I got it.
Hold on, Matt, what are the bets that are already in?
I feel like that'd be unfair for me to give away the bets of other people because you'll pull that $1 Price is Right BS move. So,
well, I'm just saying because Garza and I have to give ours out over the airwaves.
If you give a time, I have a list of all the times that have been predicted so far. If you duplicate a prediction, I will tell you, and you will have to come up with another one.
Okay, that's her. Oh, man. I think it's going to surprise some people. I think it's going to go 6 minutes, 13 seconds.
Hmm. Hmm.
6 minutes, 13 seconds.
Good job. That's not spoken for.
What?
Good job. That one's not spoken for.
Okay, the exact opposite of 316. The exact opposite.
Billy Johnson's in the chat saying Goldberg's entrance will last longer than the match. I know it's not an official time, but that is a consequential time, I guess.
Actually, we could time Goldberg's entrance and have that be on the record for Billy Johnson's time.
It's like the old WrestleMania take a shit during Undertaker's entrance challenge.
Oh, no, but we can't do that anymore because they do big stadiums now.
That is true. Long walks.
They're using carts again.
The carts.
I wouldn't mind seeing that again. I'm not going to lie.
The carts?
Yeah, I would love to see the carts back. I would love to see the carts back again.
That could be. Garza, what's your pick? What's your pick for time?
I'm going to go 1 minute with 20 seconds.
Ooh.
I love it.
There you go. There you go. All right. Quick rundown. We'll see if you guys have any comments on what is. We've obviously talked enough about Goldberg and Kevin Owens for the Universal title.
We've talked longer than that match is going to last.
Yeah, that's true. Roman Reigns, Braun Strowman. Again, if this doesn't have some kind of stiff or weird ending to it, I don't know what the hell they've been doing the last few weeks.
No, it's going to end with Taker showing up, scaring Roman Reigns, and Braun Strowman gets the win thanks to Taker's interference.
Yeah. Could be. Bayley and Charlotte.
Oh, Charlotte wins. I think this is when Sasha finally turns.
Yeah. But she helped her get the belt.
I don't know.
It could be accidental interference, though.
Okay, and then it turns into like a friends start feuding kind of thing.
I'm gonna go with what I said on Raw on the wrap up.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna say that Charlotte that Bayley gets DQ'd, so she keeps the belt, but Charlotte wins the match.
Hey, wait. So in the chat here,
whoa, Bobby!
Bobby and
is
Brandon.
That a typo?
Bobby is saying,
is that a typo?
Bobby of J-Town in the chat for a Goldberg match is saying 9 minutes and 39 seconds. Bold
I can't
move.
I can't name a 9 minute match Goldberg had in WCW.
And Brandon's out there. He's saying 2 minutes and 15 seconds.
Yeah, we've that got Brandon.
We got Brandon already.
Yeah, we've
okay.
got Brandon.
Okay. All right. Tina's calling for a Charlotte win in a 4-way at WrestleMania. Probably with I'm presuming with all the girls that we saw in the tag match last night.
Oh yeah,
I think you can still do that and have Bayley be champion.
You could. You absolutely could. But
actually, yeah, because Nia pinned her, so I guess that's how she gets in.
Yep, absolutely.
Yep.
Absolutely. Everybody deserves one at that point. We already talked
about
Zayn and Joe. I think it could very easily be a match of the night candidate, Neville and Jack Gallagher.
Does anyone think Jack Gallagher is winning?
No.
No, not really.
No. I was just checking.
Missy does.
Oh, okay. Yay.
Tag team championship, Gallows and Anderson and Enzo and Cass. This is could not make this and have a go at it at Mania. Because I feel like we're returning to the era of multi-man tag championships.
Yeah, we are. And spoiler alert, those weren't any good.
No, they weren't.
As someone who's just watched a whole lot of those, they were not very good at all.
Mm-hmm. Sasha Banks and Nia Jax. Okay. Again, we got like two cruiserweight matches, two women's matches. I mean, it's like, you know, we got enough stuff to make a card matter at this point, I think, for the most part.
Tina's asking if we think there will be a Finn Balor appearance.
I don't know where yet.
Versus Joe?
I feel like...
Well, because, see, the weird thing about Finn Balor is Seth is the one that injured him, but we're clearly not building toward Balor and Seth.
No, even less so now.
I would love to see Finn Balor kick Goldberg's head off. I would just love to see that. I want to see that. Like, if that's the reason Kevin Owens wins,
I hate to roll back, but I already have this because I still think, and I know Mike highly disagrees with me, but I think we'll see a similar to No Way Out back in the day. That it's pretty much how they set up last WrestleMania, where Brock's going to come in and kind of screw him out of the belt.
Screw Owens out of the belt?
No, but screw Goldberg out of the belt, and that sets up their match at Mania without the belt.
I'd be totally fine with that.
Mm-hmm. No, but then like Lesnar is costing himself the only chance to get the title at WrestleMania.
Yes.
But you could argue that Brock Lesnar is a mindless buffoon who just wants to fight Goldberg.
Yes.
But here we accepted the match, though.
Oh, in the meantime, we are reminded.
And plus,
that
it was Brock who eliminated Goldberg from the Royal Rumble. I mean, Goldberg who eliminated Brock. So it's more payback. Like, hey, you cost me an opportunity to title. Now I cost you an opportunity to title.
In the meantime, we are reminded once again by the internet that Virgil claims that he is the only one of the only people in the world undefeated at WrestleMania.
Sadly, sure. That is accurate.
Yep.
Sadly, that. But then again, so is Snooki. So
yeah.
So I mean, you know, elite company.
So
elite
is
company.
So is Akabono.
Hey, that was a much better match than you had.
Yeah.
So is friend of the show Butterbean.
True. True too. True too. Floyd Mayweather. What's happening in the chat room? Is there something happening in the chat room?
Billy Johnson's comment is actually what I oohed when you were talking about the Finn Balor appearance. So Billy Johnson's comment got an ooh out of me over Finn Balor. Neville wins. Austin Aries attacks after the match.
I don't like see that. Austin yeah. attacking Neville. Do you really think Austin's going to be a good guy?
No, I just think he's going to be a bad guy that really wants to just
go
after the belt.
I guess so.
I think we're getting a cruiserweight multi-man at Mania, though.
Oh, easy.
We have to be. Like, you know,
I feel like I need a ladder match. There's going to be a ladder match.
Ooh, mm-hmm. I don't know if I want that to be a ladder match.
Oh, Mad Mike. Tina's also mentioning the house show for New York.
Yes.
Let's mention this for context.
I really want to go to this show really badly. In White Plains, New York, I was telling Sorg this last night, there is an advertised house show match that's Triple H, Samoa Joe, and Kevin Owens versus Sami Zayn, Chris Jericho, and Finn Balor. So, holy fuck.
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And he sent photographic evidence to the Wrestling Mayhem Show Facebook as well. So thank you. I appreciate that.
Yes, because we did do the Pixar didn't happen thing.
Pixar didn't happen, and he delivered.
Holy crap. If someone asks me for picks, I always deliver.
Mike,
ladies.
I need to ask, how good are your Photoshop skills?
They are dreadful.
Okay, just making sure that's a legit pick then.
Good point. Missy, I use MS Paint.
Mm.
Hey, my mom is really good with MS Paint.
Chachi's really good at that too. Yeah, he did a lot of his logo work for Chachi Says.
I am not.
Let's just be clear. No.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Uh-huh.
Right. My skills are not lit.
Mm.
Your skills are not on fire.
Speaking of lit, Wheels is saying with the Wyatt compound burnt down, do we see Husky Harris return?
That would actually be hilarious.
This is why we're all laughing.
He has a weird flashback and wow. Wait, he wakes up as Husky Harris and he's like, I just had
and he's wearing dream. And he's wearing a new he's wearing a Nexus t-shirt.
Yes.
He's wearing a Nexus t-shirt in the WWE championship.
And he rolls over in bed and CM Punk is laying next to him. Hi, Husky.
and then SmackDown has its series finale and it's just like Dallas.
Exactly. It's more like the Bob Newhart show, but yeah, you got it.
Okay, yeah.
Newhart. I'm sorry. Don't yeah, email us. All right.
As long as it's less like the last season of Roseanne, I'm okay.
Oh no. We can't have Dan die again.
Spoiler alert.
Somebody's working. Be on SmackDown.
The Luke Harper. I don't know.
Eric Rowan. Oh my God, he's already dead.
Oh no! Oh no!
Oh no! Eric Rowan's already gone.
Anyways. All right, moving it around. What the hell is next on my agenda? Well, hey, let's give a shout out to our good friends at Slice on Broadway, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting with the perfect pepperoni pizza. And we got plenty to talk about after that. The support getting so many people in here. You know, some people they aren't even on the show. Like they're just hanging out here. I mean, look at Katie's just around. She's like, she's not even doing anything that has to do with wrestling. She's like doing.
She has a very important job tonight.
What is that?
Fire! Fire! See?
There you go. And people just hanging out here at Mayhem Studio, getting them more. And I always think we got a cooler vibe when we got people in person as much as possible. And we're bringing in that local crew here with us. And that's partially thanks to our friends at Slice on Broadway, sliceonbroadway.com here in Beachview along the tracks, as well as Main Street down in Carnegie, PA, down at Slice on Broadway, PNC Park location, home of the Pittsburgh Pirates at PNC Park. Opening days like beginning of April? Is that right? You're a baseball person over there, right?
What about baseball?
Preseason, PNC Park?
Spring training.
Spring training is happening. Never mind. Sorry. Never mind. I don't think they're moving Slice on Broadway down to Florida for that. But still, you can go and partake. Our good friends that work on the north side do all the time over there that work for some kind of newspaper or something. So thanks to them for supporting the show, sliceonbroadway.com, PGH_slice on the Twitters, and let them know The Mayhem Show sent you. Okay, guys.
Sorg, before we move into the next segment, Billy Johnson added on to our Bray Wyatt waking up as Husky Harris theory.
Okay.
Somebody he's wondering he's wondering if Bo Dallas wakes up as Sister Abigail.
Wow. Just with a wig, like a blonde wig, like a horrible blonde wig, right?
I'm so down for this. I believe in this shit.
We should just reenact this. Anyways, there was some news. As we were watching Raw, more exciting things were happening that didn't have anything to do with Raw yet, at least. Okay.
Hold on. Sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm catching up on some of these comments that were in here. Sorry.
As the resident TNA man, I will break the news.
Okay.
The Broken Hardys are now obsolete. They left TNA. They left TNA.
They're
deleted. They're gone.
Yes.
What are they going to do with all those Jeff Hardy baseball bats, Sorg?
Oh no.
Don West needs to know.
Why did we sign so many?
Why was Jeff Hardy signing baseball bats in the first place?
Didn't they have these baseball events that didn't go anywhere? Or am I thinking GFL?
Yeah, but he was Willow then.
I can't keep up. That was your job, remember?
I'm trying. It's very difficult.
But anyways, so as it broke through the day, there were rumors about the Hardys not re-signing, and finally kind of confirmed with tweets, including one of Reby Hardy. Who's Reby?
Yeah.
Who am I even confusing her with? But Reby. No, I'm not drinking. I saw that over there. I am not drinking. This is just coffee.
The least you could do is share.
Coffee. I swear, it's just coffee from my wonderful, awesome cost mug. It's just
Sorg is drinking vodka soaked in D batteries.
That sounds like almost a great idea. But anyways, kind of going off about TNA. The word is, hold on, let me pull up our article.
Remy's actual tweet is really amazing. It was all the frustration I've had with TNA, basically summed up.
Okay.
Well, I'll bring up the actual tweet so I can get the context for you. But yeah, Reby went off on TNA management. I was really appreciative of her.
And so much like I didn't like her tweets like drop into Spanish at some point too. Like it was probably pretty great. So supposedly amongst this, Drew Galloway also supposedly on his way out. Mike and Maria, by the way, have re-signed contracts. So
whoopty fucking do.
come on, Drunk Mike was the best part of that wedding.
Yeah, easily. That's because I just wanted to be him. I wanted to be a Drunk Mike watching that show.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's true too. But beyond that, supposedly they're restructuring contracts, including changing some of the contracts to paying people on per day of work as opposed to per episode. So say friend of the show DJZ does matches on two of the four tapings in a night, right? He gets paid per appearance, which could be matches, promos, etc. Right? Now it's going to be per day. Would you automatically kind of taking the wind out of what they pay these guys a little bit? On top of that, they're trying to get 10% of sales out with other promotions. So we're thinking merch, Hardy's coming to IWC here in a couple months, you know, what they would make from IWC and the charity event that they're doing, 10% would go to Impact Wrestling. This is a troubled Impact Wrestling squeezing the lemon for everything it can.
Oh, okay. Here's what Reby said. Unreal with the little bitch shit. Unreal. Why try to do things the right way when you get BS and drama in return? Matt is a nice guy. I'll keep the shits hostage. Fuck out of here. because TNA is so smart, they decided to keep their tag titles on a team that they weren't sure was going to resign.
Well, to be fair, there was...
Nope. I'm sorry. This was filmed 3 months ago.
3 months?
Probably.
Okay.
No.
The expedition to gold?
Yeah, but the whole contract thing just happened yesterday.
Yeah, right, I know, right. But they knew when the contracts were up.
But there was contract negotiations around the beginning of the year. So these had already been. And this is a long process, Mike. So everybody was under the understanding that they were going to proceed with new contract, whether it be verbal or whatever the case may be, right? Which is probably a mistake, to be granted. And then TNA came back with the different things, and their lawyer stepped up and says, "This is a horrible idea. Don't sign this," right? They came back and changed things because they were under new management. I keep going back to, I think the creative up until probably whatever happens at the tapings this month is highly divorced from the new owners, despite the owls getting everywhere. By the way, have you appreciated my man owls pictures I've been posting in the Facebook for you?
I want you
to visualize. One, what Jeff Jarrett will be dressed as when he comes back as creative officer. And two,
Sorg, they could have Dolores fucking Umbridge show up and start talking about owls, and I still wouldn't be approval of TNA.
I do not understand that reference.
Harry Potter.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
So, but in contrast to Revy's response, Matt has just saying my stint with Impact Wrestling was delightful, exceptional talent in locker room, great, respectful team that worked hard on tough times. I mean, taking some different tactics here. And even Jeff Jarrett came back and says, you know, hey, those guys are going to do great wherever they end up, you know, best.
I think it's funny that the past month on TNA, Matt's been talking about going back to his roots. And they'll probably end up back in their roots.
Exactly.
If you get it.
Well, my question about the Ruby comment. Last I knew, she was pregnant.
Right. Again?
She still is.
Exactly. This is pregnancy hormones.
Oh, get her away from Twitter.
Oh, I don't think that's it.
There you go.
No, Missy. As someone who has known people who have had personal interactions with Reby Hardy, no, it ain't.
wait, to be fair, we have had a personal interaction with Reby. She was the one.
It was delightful.
Was it? There was kind of a snafu over a table last I remembered.
Delightful. That got cleared up. Okay.
Did you have more interactions with Reby than I recall?
With regard to the table and stuff, I mean, okay. She asked a couple of different questions as far as where to find things.
So you interacted with Reby more than any of us here that I'm aware of. So.
Yeah, no.
How would you take Reby in a personal setting?
She was perfectly fine, mm-hmm. and normal, and pretty much what I would expect for someone to be traveling with a wrestler and running their merch stand and the relationship that she has with him. Mm-hmm. Like, it was entirely what I expected.
Okay. Well, there's some context for you. So, are you surprised by her comments and railing on Twitter about this?
I'm not a huge fan of TNA, so I've not really watched much of it other than the occasional stuff that I am subjected to.
That I've made you watch, like the final deletion.
Yeah. Sorg, you're the worst husband! You're the worst husband, Sorg!
So, we've established this on Monday nights that I'm the worst husband.
Just Monday nights?
And Thursday nights when we do midweek.
Only on nights when wrestling is on. Never mind. All right, you're right.
And when I make you watch New Japan...
Yes. So,
by the way, recovering your password, and we forget which secret question you used on a Japanese website is really, really hard. And I really want to watch Honor Rising. So if anybody can help me out there,
you should just put every answer for your secret question: Domo Arigato, Mr. Robot.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yes! But now anybody can recover my password. Anyways, Missy, you have something important to say.
What was I saying?
I don't know. The response and classiness of a Mrs. Hardy.
Oh yeah, given the fact of how much unrest that there's been in TNA, and this is being again somebody completely on the fringe, not having anything to do with watching it regularly.
But you see the stories come across the wire
exactly,
from week to week here.
Exactly. It would be the same response that I would have, to be honest. Just be like, WTF, seriously, what's really? That would have been my response.
Right, exactly. And here's, hold on. And here's kind of my response to this. So there was a post, another post by WrestleZone where it was like the updates of like the changes. One, Dutch Mantel's up colder is now in charge of creative, and he used to be too. And I think
that's a good thing.
Like you guys agree, like when Dutch was in charge, it was some of the better years of TNA, right?
I'm on board with Dutch being in charge.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, so good. Yeah, we got a good head behind everything there. This is where it gets weird. It is what I mentioned, right? I won't go over the 10% thing, the four tapings and everything like that. And then Jeff Jarrett is chief creative officer now. The maybe I have on this, no word on him wearing an Al suit. Hashtag business Al. Hashtag not my business Al. Hashtag not my Jeff Jarrett. But anyways.
Oh, hashtag not my Jeff Jarrett. As if there's another one. A good one. There's no good Jeff Jarrett.
Hashtag not my impact. So there's definitely some things going on there, and I don't know. Wow, there's a lot of expletives in that quote. but I don't know. This isn't something that obviously they need a reset, but if they're not in a position with things like this to attract talent that they need to, they don't have a track record of building talent that WWE hasn't done better job with. Look at, I don't know, the last two nights.
Anyone in WrestleMania. Look at anyone in WrestleMania.
Look at NXT on up. Look at Mandrews. Look at Samoa Joe. Look at AJ Styles. Look at even Christopher Daniels on Ring of Honor. I don't know.
Mandrews has gotten more exposure in 3 hours of WWE programming than he did for a year plus of TNA.
Exactly. So, look at Kurt Angle in the Hall of Fame. I'm sorry. Random thing that I just read before the show.
How many people are in both Hall of Fames? Is it just Kurt?
Sting.
Oh, right, of course.
Sting. I'm waiting for that Earl Hebner. I'm waiting for that Earl Hebner.
That's not going to happen.
Anytime soon.
That'll happen posthumously.
What the hell was I watching? I was watching the Skywalkers on the highlights for Rock and Roll Express, and I think that's Earl Hebner as referee in that. Like in 87-ish?
It might be Dave Hebner.
Oh! Freaking.
How can there be two Earl Hebner?
Freaking twins. The original Bella switch. Anyways.
The Hebners. The original Bellas.
OG. The OGs.
Sorg, does that mean they're the Beta Bellas?
The Beta Bellas. The Hebners. We got it wrong the first time. We went back to the lab and we got the Bellas. Anyways.
They're sitting there thinking, what didn't work about this? Maybe if we make them hot, maybe that'll work. Yes!
Why do you think John Laurinaitis is so involved
now
with that family?
Now you screwed Brett means something entirely different.
Hey-o! Well, we'll see what that's like at WrestleMania. God, man, can we... I'm going to save that Mayhem Mania coming alive tonight thing.
We're canon, Sork!
Like, did you... I that was bad over there. Dude, did you watch tonight?
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Was your brain exploding at this thing happening?
I kind of saw the writing on the wall, so it didn't come as a total shock.
No,
to me. This
of
happening.
Course. But, like, still, to see it happening before your eyes as the opening segment of SmackDown. And I miss most, we were still doing Awesome Cats, but I saw the visuals of what was happening and then some of the backstage interview stuff. And it was just like wait. Is this our fault? Like
the only thing, there's only like basically two more steps they needed to take to make our match.
Yeah.
And that was just Rusev Machka and they come out and then, you know, bomb, you know, cue Motorhead and then it's on. It's right there. That's all they had to do.
Man, Wow. I don't have anything else to say about that.
I wanted to say that I did get to see that segment and I'm sitting there thinking because sometimes I feel like they match Cena up in the promo department against guys who aren't quite on his level. But at the beginning of the segment, I'm like, okay, The Miz. The Miz has been around for a long time. The Miz can talk. The Miz can act. The Miz has got it all. The Miz can stand toe-to-toe and trade words with John Cena. John Cena had him dead to rights in like two sentences. It was over. I'm like, damn you! You know.
Well, what I'm waiting for, and I was talking about this to someone on Twitter, I want Miz to bring up Cena's divorce.
We have time.
I know. And I'm waiting for that. Like, because especially Cena telling the Miz to man up, I want Miz to say, "Hey, Cena, I know you had a crappy divorce. Why don't you man up and put a ring on it?" Like, and then I'm calling it. I'm calling it right now. All right, are you ready for this? Bold prediction from Mad Mike. After the tag match at WrestleMania, Cena proposes in the middle of the ring.
Ooh. And Nikki turns heel.
We have a wedding at SummerSlam. Because that's going to go well.
Yes! A match made in heaven, a match made in hell. Rusev gives them a snake. Or a Russian bear with a ring around it.
I just like the idea that they're doing a reception and he drives a tank through it.
I'll also accept that.
I might have seen that in a movie too.
Or Randy Orton gives them a viper.
Or if Randy Orton burns the tent down.
But if anyone's wedding is pay-per-view worthy, it is Cena's. So.
Yeah, I mean, and it's something that you can build, like, because when's the last time Total Divas, Total Bellas built to a pay-per-view? like led to you wanting to get the WWE Network in particular?
Well, they do build to pay-per-views, Sorg, but the problem is they tape 6 months behind.
Yeah, I know.
So anyways. They do build the pay-per-views. But
Bobby, I don't read the internet in those places.
Bobby saying
Dave Meltzer, who's that? That's
who's
not
he ever beat.
Dave
who's
Meltzer's fake beat? News. Anyways,
no one has a 6-star match. Fuck you.
Credibility.
That's
what's
like
that?
Giving 110%. It's not possible, Sorg.
No. I can only give what is the full amount of my body, and that actually just stops at 95%. Hashtag not my double J. Brandon wants us to talk about Foley.
Why?
He was talking to me last night about it a little bit, about things. Okay. Everybody other than Mike, cause I know your thoughts on this. We talked about last night.
Yeah.
They're leading Foley up. Is he just leading out the door? Or they're going to do something with him. I don't know. I feel like more of, Daniel Bryan having something to do with Miz coming up here is more likely than fully doing anything. But I'm kind of tired of just Stephanie dressing people down for no reason.
It sucks.
I'm just tired of
it sucks.
Stephanie just needs to go away.
It's not because Foley and Steph are bad performers. It sucks. So I blame the writers, and you know, I blame the person who allows the writing to get on the TV set. You know, that is,
it just
he's the old guy. Yeah, but Mick is just, you know, he has these like spurts of like really, you know, fiery, you know, speeches for like no reason. He just starts to go off like he sounds some crazy old man. He's like, "When I was in Hell in a Cell and I got thrown off that cage and I was doing it because I love wrestling and I'm crazy and you need to be crazy and love wrestling too." But then the rest of the time he's just a bumbling idiot. I don't know. I mean, that's the way he's being portrayed.
Like some of the things like where like didn't he like try to talk Sasha out of Hell in a Cell, and then let's say I was trying to see if you had it in you, kid. You know, like again, like it's not special because he does it every other week that he's yelling about something in passion, right?
Yeah, just compare. I mean, it's so easy to see. I mean, just compare the way you know they handle Stephen Foley to the way they handle you know Brian and Shane on SmackDown. You see Shane once every like 2 months. Brian, granted, not all of his decisions make a lot of sense, but he doesn't go out there and, you know, oversell, you know, overdo it. He just goes out there and he says, "We're going to do this because of this, and that's the way it's going to be." And I think, you know, in that kind of a role, I mean, I think you need to be a little bit more understated so that, yeah, whenever things really get out of hand, you can be like flying off the handle, like, "Oh my god, all hell is breaking loose!" And
yeah,
you know,
like they should just watch all of the Dario Cueto segments from seasons 1 and 2 of Lucha Underground.
There you go. There you go. From there to managing the champion with the key. By the way, I'm one episode away from Ultimate Lucha Dos. And I think when that happens, I'm going to sit down and watch the entirety of Ultimate Lucha Dos. Like the entire 3 hours.
As you should.
Like just together. I have to, right?
Mm-hmm. As you should, Sorg.
Getting very, very excited about that. From the chat, Tina's saying that Joe will take a hit out on Foley. It's coming, Sigh.
I don't think it is because Mick needs hip surgery.
Yeah, there's nothing really physical.
I don't think he's actually going to take a bump.
Nothing visual. Like, go ahead.
Yeah.
You don't have to see it on camera.
No. Guys, did you have something?
No, I was just going to agree that it's going to be those when he's just found dead.
he's just found dead.
Or maybe.
Oh my God, they killed Foley! You bastards!
Or maybe just the van pulls up and throws him in the back and nobody cares about him for 6 weeks, right?
Hey. That's been done. And we finally know who that was. That was people from the NXT Performance Center.
Oh, exactly. Hashtag forgotten Samoan. Hashtag not my Joe.
This is a rescue.
This is a rescue. We're saving your career. We're saving your career.
Come with me if you want to live.
Yes, come with me.
Can those same people show up and kidnap EC3 too? And maybe,
yes, please.
And maybe Zima, please?
Yes.
Can the same people do that? Please.
Hashtag free Zima.
Oh my Sorg. Every tweet I have for Impact this week, hashtag free Zima. that's what's gonna happen now.
Yeah, a lot of people want some free drinks.
Hashtag free Zima.
Just be very careful with that because I understand the Zima drink might be coming back. So
that's fine.
Just, I mean, it might confuse the message a little bit.
Sorg, views are views.
Yes, but if one actually gets a friend hired and one gets us a delicious adult beverage, it's a different goal.
Zima the drink is spelled with an I. Zima the professional wrestler is spelled with an E. It's okay.
I think he'll even self admit how bad of spelling issues he's had with his career.
Well, didn't Shima Zion have two eyes?
Yes, it did, and we always got it wrong on this show, and never really knew how to pronounce his name for a while. So
yeah, I remember there are a lot of episodes of Shima Zion.
Yes, there was.
Even though in the Matrix Reloaded, it told us how to pronounce Zion.
That's right. That's right. Is there huge news on Tom Phillips? What's happening there?
Oh, no, I just said Tom Phillips looks like he's sitting at the big boy table at Thanksgiving.
Oh, okay. All right, sure.
He does. If you look at those announcer on-cams, it's like JBL said, oh, why don't you come up here and sit with the big boys, kid?
He's the smallest guy, and he's at the far end of the table to make him look even tinier, plus being on the other side of JBL, who was like, what, 6'6"? Right? It's the worst idea ever.
It's the big kids table.
It is.
It's exactly what it is.
I mean, we do the right thing and put Rizz this angle here, Rizz goes first because he's shorter than everybody that's in.
You go middle out. Everyone knows that.
Middle out.
I know. You're thinking of Silicon Valley, aren't you, Sorg?
A little bit. Anyways, oh shit. On that note, I don't even know. See,
hey, Sorg, before we break, do you want me to discuss my secret project?
Yes, this would be a perfect time for an in-house ad. Tell us what's coming up there. What do you have in the hopper here? What are people going to be experiencing in the Mad Mike land very, very soon?
Okay, so I decided to do something a little insane. And I decided to give you guys 32 days of content. What I've done, and I'm just about done now, I've watched every single WrestleMania. And starting March 2nd, I believe it is, we will be releasing one podcast per day until WrestleMania with me talking about every single WrestleMania that's occurred.
So what can we expect from this? Because I did a similar thing a few years ago leading up to WrestleMania 30. So, mm-hmm. You know, it was about oh, about what, 20 hours less than you have to watch now. So if I do the math right with kickoff shows, well, even without, but what do we have to expect from this other than your slow descent into madness?
No, actually it hasn't been that bad. Basically I break down the entire card. I talk about, the general atmosphere and vibe of each WrestleMania. And then I just run down the card match by match. Like, and some of those WrestleManias have a lot of fucking matches on them. But right now I'm in the middle of WrestleMania 25, and I should be done within like a week or two. But yeah, right now there are 24 podcasts in the hopper, ready to go. And it's what I like to call 32 Manias with Mike. So yeah, that's going to be coming this week.
There you go. And we will, I believe, no, I'm not going to tell it. It will be at least in video form on the Facebook and the YouTube page. I'm not sure if we're distributing it yet on, I have to do something technical in order for that to happen to be on the super feed. It might be on the super feed.
Okay.
So look out for that. And I think we're going to start it. Are we starting it tomorrow?
March 2nd.
Second. Okay, so I'll be setting that up tomorrow. Yes. So that will be coming out. Excellent. So look out for that.
And don't worry, they're only like 20-25 minutes each. It's not long.
Yeah.
So they're nice. They're like nice little brief windows into my
nuggets.
Soul.
Little nuggets for you to get into the WrestleMania season. And damn it, it is the WrestleMania season. I'll also be interesting, and maybe you would along with this project. Are you going to be rewatching any WrestleManias over the next month or so before the Mania? You know, which ones, why, what are your thoughts? Are you seeing ones that you're familiar with? Are you seeing ones that you haven't watched in a while and see how they hold up? So, John Fun responding to your secret project, the world domination of sorts.
Yes.
Well, that's this entire project here.
I mean, that is the ultimate goal.
Hmm.
That is the ultimate goal.
Oh,
world domination,
geez,
through wrestling habits.
sorry, I just got to fill it in on what, poor choice of words, on what Tom Phillips had done. Apparently, according to Billy, he was messaging a girl about having a raging erection as he sits on a plane, and it apparently popped out on Twitter.
That was actually one of the subtitles for one of the WrestleManias.
wait, which part?
The Raging Climax.
Oh, no. Oh, no. All right. On that note, I don't know what sponsor I'm having up next, and I feel sorry for them. I'm sure it's one of our own. We'll be right back with the big question, followed closely by Mayhem Mania. Let's talk tech. Tech news discussions from the people in the industry right here in Pittsburgh. Online, gadgets, startups, and more. Check it out at awesomecast.net. Wrestling Mayhem Show. We're getting so mayhemy up in here. Mad Mike with us, as is Antonio Garza. Bobby FJ Town joining us. Riz joining us. And on the couch, Mainstream Matt and Dudders to roll.
Guys,
we have one mic.
I need to turn. No, you have a mic.
I didn't want to move it.
Well, yeah, go ahead and move it. Go ahead and move it. We didn't set you up. Whoops. And Dutter's with us here for Mayhem Mania. What?
Guys, you gotta subscribe to Patreon this week.
No, I wasn't recording any of that. That's on the Facebook stream.
Are you serious?
Only. Yeah, that's why you gotta join us here live.
Well, you gotta sign up anyway, even though Sorg doesn't record.
Not always,
funny
man.
Shit.
You never know. You know, well, there's there's too much. I thought we were gonna go right in the show. Then that didn't happen.
Me trying to find keys with a flashlight.
But anyways, it's time for the big question. Mad Mike, please proceed with the big question.
The big question should be, where are Bobby's keys?
There's no light.
Same place as the gerbil. All right, moving on.
Guys, producer, yes? Missy is putting on her producer hat. She's also putting on her cranky Missy hat. So this means get the show started.
I was about to even do a big question. All right, okay. So big question. We now know the rumor that, not a rumor anymore, that the Hardys have left TNA.
What?
So the big question for everyone this week, the big question for everyone this week, and you don't need to have watched TNA to do this, because okay. it's the Hardy Boys, so pretty much anything goes. How would you write off the Hardys?
Oh. All right, all right. Man.
It's a good one.
Yeah, it might be a little too complicated a little bit.
All right, Sorg, I'll go with mine first. I would just have Josh Matthews put on his very serious voice and just say, ladies and gentlemen, it's come to our attention that Vanguard 1 has accidentally teleported Matt and Jeff Hardy into the Bermuda Triangle. We're sorry for their loss. And then they cut to Bobby Lashley fighting some jobber. That's it.
So regular okay. TNA episode,
basically.
Okay, all right. I like that.
I got one.
Okay, go ahead.
So my trick is we're gonna get rid of the Hardy Jeff Hardy vessels, but the essence, the souls, are staying with TNA in the forms of, I don't know, like another kangaroo and a monkey. Or, I don't know. Probably we can get like a Jeff Jarrett guitar from Don West and some Jeff Hardy headbands, and those are the new vessels.
Oh my god, I love it!
Jeff Hardy and Jeff Hardy.
All right, I got one.
All right,
the end of Poochie episode.
What?
Just have dinos okay. Yes, planet. Yes, that's it. That's all you have to do. That's how you write them off. And then you say, hey, we're going to have a title. We're going to have like this tournament bullshit with points and whatever. But they won't matter in the end because, you know, it's probably going to go back to somebody in GFW. Who fucking cares? I don't know. Yeah, that's how they're gonna
write them. All right. Oh, Missy's got one.
They're going to go with a Scooby-Doo ending.
I love the Scooby-Doo ending.
But who's Matt Hardy? And they would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for you.
Wait.
They would have gotten away with it if it wasn't for that rock star Spud.
Yes. Yeah. Yep. That makes sense.
Riz?
Who's Matt Hardy in this situation?
Old
Man Withers?
No. Senior Benjamin.
Wait, Matt Hardy is Senior Benjamin?
Sure. Really? Is that the thing that doesn't make sense in all this? Let's come on in the long run. All right, is anybody else? I don't think we're gonna have everybody answer this one, but Katie's got one.
I got one too. They're gonna fall down an elevator shaft. They're gonna be like leaving to get in an elevator, and then like, oh no, there's no elevator here, and fall down the elevator shaft.
Like L.A. Law?
No, like the end of it. Like Friends.
Oh, okay.
When they got rid of Drake Ramore.
Katie, I know you're kidding, but Mickey James got hit by a train once.
That's true.
No.
Didn't get rid of her.
Pushed Mickey James off into a train.
Billy Johnson saying write them off as mining for gold for Jeff Jarrett. There you go. Anybody else got one?
I think I would like to see like a very noble moment of self-sacrifice. So maybe you bring Dixie back for just one episode. And everyone thinks like, oh my god, no, Dixie's back, and Matt and Jeff are like, we gotta do something, we gotta save the Impact. We have to save the Impact Zone, the Zone of Impact. And they get out there with Vanguard 1 and they go to teleport Dixie, but they need more power or something like that. And they just teleport themselves with Dixie just back 10,000 years with Vanguard, but leave Vanguard 1 in the Impact Zone. So they have no way of returning. And they'll put a plaque up in the Impact Zone in memory of
Man, you know, so there is a question on whether they can use the broken character outside of TNA,
yeah.
which could they are. Would suck, right? Mm-hmm. Like it might have to stay with TNA. So what if, in kind of this, like you had the idea of them kind of transferring? Garza, you had that, right? Like it becomes, and I feel like this fits here, another little bit of TNA. I know it becomes Rockstar Spud and Aaron Rex.
No.
I didn't say it'd be good. Okay.
I'm laughing because I want to see that.
As long as it's Matt Hardy in Rockstar Spud and Jeff Hardy yes. and Aaron Rex.
Yeah, yes. I'm in. All right. Bobby,
that'd be weird.
That's
the only way it works.
My thing was
excellent.
They try to escape from TNA on the dilapidated boat, but it starts to sink. And then all of a sudden, Vanguard 1 swoops down and picks both of them up and carries them off. And they look down and there's a goodbye spot out in the rocks. Like, match.
And all you hear is the theme from Titanic.
No, the theme from
that
match.
Could work too.
Okay. Theme from Match works too.
Oh, wow. Anybody else? I think that's everybody, right? All right. Yeah. That's a big question. Let us know. How would you write the Hardys off of TNA Wrestling?
Please be as descriptive as possible. I will read them during my live tweet.
At Mayhem Show on Twitter or hashtag WMS Big Question. Mike, make sure when you do the live tweet to resurface this question for anybody watching on Thursday nights too. I think they'll appreciate that.
Oh, please. Yeah, I'm going to.
Yes. I know you get a lively conversation going on Thursdays that I have to wake up to. More particularly, I'm on one of my other jobs and I see my Twitter blowing up my phone and a lot of angry responses.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So. And sometimes people just like my thoughts.
There you go. And for some reason, Marty the Moth likes a bunch of them too. So
he's a lovely man that doesn't know how wings work.
What's up, Marty? We don't think you're as creepy as the Lucha Underground audience does.
Yes, we do.
Maybe a little
bit. I was going to say something.
Maybe a little bit. Anyways, what's next? Oh, hey, plugging our friends, indiewrestling.us. What do we do on this show? Hey, I just want to give a shout out to indiewrestling.us.
We plug our friends.
Including some great write-ups lately by Trey. Trey Gar has been writing about the women's wrestling. And we've had some great interviews with the Indie Mayhem Show, Angel Dust, David Starr, Jackson Argos, and so much more. Kid Cadet had a wonderful conversation with Kid Cadet last week that we'll be posting this Thursday over there. And check out new stuff like Premier Championship Wrestling out of Cleveland. With Joe Dombrowski, our friend of the show, and some other friends up there doing some really good stuff. Just announced out of that promotion is the welterweight tournament and championship. I believe it's going to be under 185 pounds, and we will be distributing that, I believe, here past April when that happens. So looking forward to that, and look, we'll probably be talking with some people here on the show in the near future for that. Something really interesting. A great speech by Joe Dombrowski about that. But on top of that, you also soon have IWC's Proving Ground from this weekend. A lot of new talent. I mean, a lot of people debuted on that show previously, including Britt Baker, who's popped up on Ring of Honor and Monday Night Raw. Amongst a bunch of other places. I just saw that she's going to be in Orlando for, is that Shimmer? Yeah, that's Shimmer. Talked to her this weekend about that. She's excited to be a part of that as well. Rise Championship, all that kind of stuff. Check out some of her early matches, her entire IWC career, including becoming the IWC Women's Champion at indiewrestling.us. And sign up for the email address. I'm sorry, the newsletter there for updates on sales of stuff going on. I was completely going to put one up until Amazon Web Services went down today. But thanks,
that
Amazon.
Was so much fun.
That, yeah, a lot of people affected by that, including the back end of our service as well. But they've been really great to us and helping us improve things around there as well. So check it out. Sign up for the newsletter at indiewrestling.us. Now it is time for Mayhem Mania, Matt Carlin's.
Oh, so much to do.
What is happening?
I made a list. We got a lot to get through.
Okay.
So we'll try to be quick. All right. This is Mayhem Mania. It's kind of a competitive thought experiment where we are trying to make the optimum best WrestleMania card possible within the bounds of our current reality. That means every human being comes in their current contractual, emotional, and physical state. No fudging, even though. Yeah, there's some fudging. And also hurt feelings, so that'll be fun too. We are trying, the goal, essentially, as we work through what we call the undercard, to create a supercard. If something makes it on the undercard, survives three rounds on the undercard, it graduates to the supercard, and the person who created the match that graduates to the supercard, he gets reward! So, Sorg, let's quickly go over the supercard and the two matches that have graduated to the supercard, and they are... The American Alpha versus the Kings of Wrestling versus The Revival, which was created by Bobby FJ Town. Just graduated last week, so Bobby is back, and he's going to get his rewards here in just a moment. But I also want to mention our other graduated match, Brock Lesnar versus Kevin Owens, which was created by the IWC Rookie of the Year, Jackson Argus. Bobby, how are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Welcome back.
Wow.
We are going to
good answer.
We are going to get you in here to start with your reward. Okay. But first, Sorg, we're going to run through the seven matches that are on our undercard.
Okay.
I might have just gone back on the thing I just said a minute ago about what we were going to do. But that's okay.
That's all right.
We're trying to do this quickly. All right. Most of you guys know the rules. So here are the seven matches, and we're going to need one more from Bobby. And so here are the matches right now as they stand on the undercard. We got John Cena and Nikki Bella versus The Miz and Maryse versus Rusev and Lana versus Triple H and Stephanie McMahon, created by Rob Brown. Then we have The Shield versus The New Day, created by Mad Mike. We've got Jack Gallagher versus Simon Gotch, created by Missy, wife of the show. We've got Samoa Joe versus Braun Strowman, created by Hot Wheels. We have Elias Sampson versus AJ Styles versus Shinsuke Nakamura, created by Bobby FJ Town. We have Raven versus Bray Wyatt, created by Jackson Argus.
I talked to him Saturday about this. He is super excited that this made it through.
And finally, we have Diamond Dallas Page versus Goldberg, created by Mutilated Larry. We want to have eight matches on the undercard so that when our other five players come in this week to start making changes to our seven matches on the undercard, they're going to have something to work with. So, Bobby, let's talk about what you get for graduating a match last week. You're going to get to create a match here in a moment to fill this hole on this card. You're going to get to eliminate / delete any wrestler you want from Mayhem Mania this year so that he can no longer be used. He or she can no longer be used going forward. And you are going to get to decide who is going to get this week's punishment. And your choices are going to be this week's players, which are Mad Mike, Sorg, Dudders, Antonio Garza, and The Rizz. So that's something to think about for you real quick. Bobby, do you know what match you want to create this week?
I do know what match I want to create. Since we don't have any proper women's wrestling on that card, I'm going to go with Charlotte versus Asuka.
Ooh.
I like it.
I would like to see that.
Excellent, excellent.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Bobby.
You're welcome.
Who would you like to eliminate or delete from Mayhem Mania?
I don't know.
Already deleted.
Ryback's already deleted.
It's been deleted from Mayhem Mania. We're going to have to start keeping a deleted list now, so that'll be fun.
So, I can't delete anybody that's on the card right now.
You cannot delete someone who's on the card right now.
Okay, so I think I'm going to pull Vince McMahon. And since he was not eligible to compete at WrestleMania last year, I'm going to throw Titus O'Neil on that eliminator list.
All right, good job. He can never be too careful.
Sorry,
Titus.
I know that.
Robert.
I know that. I feel bad for the guy, but I mean, Vince McMahon has to hate him. He lost in like 30.
Bobby just ruined my move.
That Sheamus broke.
Yeah. I was going to put some prime time players Titus somewhere around here.
Seriously.
Sorry, Bobby. Guys.
I didn't know who to pick.
Who will get the punishment this week?
I think he knows who. because he didn't know the impact on wrestling that Dave Meltzer has. Mike?
Damn it.
I'm sorry.
You specify your mic. Mad Mike, okay.
Wow.
Mad Mike. Because
Bobby.
Because everybody knew that story coming in the WrestleMania weekend.
No, I've never heard that.
You know what?
Really?
It's all about pettiness and hurt feelings here. All
right,
so
all right. That works all right, for that's me. Fine. That's fine.
That's the only reason.
That's fine.
All right. Well, this works great because Mad Mike is the first player this week. Mike, you're going to have the regular three moves. You're going to have your, you know, your swap one guy for one guy, one tag team for one tag team. You're going to have your kill a match entirely and create a new one. You're going to have your add a wrestler to or tag team to an existing match. And we have, I do want to point out, one-time use only subtract move option is in play.
If you're on audio, there's physically the subtract is here in the studio.
There's the subtract ticket to emphasize that this is only going to be used once, and once it's used, we're going to destroy it. We're going to light it on fire and throw it into the shed
fire. Don't light anything on fire.
Don't light anything on fire.
We'll take the whole
house
down.
Have we not learned from Randy Orton on SmackDown tonight?
Yes, yes.
I learned some things from Randy Orton.
I mean Kane.
That's right. But actually, Mad Mike, I'm going to have to do a supplemental ruling for you and tell you that you're not going to be able to use the subtract option because you're going to be obligated to use the wrestler that is forced upon you
by
this week's punishment, which is the wheel of women who are never, ever going to beat Asuka. Let's take a look who's on the wheel. Your NXT stalwarts. We've got Aaliyah. We've got Nikki Cross. We've got Billie Kay. We've got Ember Moon. We've got Liv Morgan. We've got Peyton Royce. Six big names. Sorg, spin the wheel.
Yeah.
Hold on. So it's just...
Here it goes. And we're landing on... Oh, no. Peyton
Congratulations,
Royce.
Mike.
Oh, Peyton Royce.
There's nothing wrong with Peyton Royce.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. He's great. All right, I got this. This is fine.
Pretty sure there's only...
No, Matt, we got this.
You got this under control?
Good.
All right.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to delete and replace. We're going to delete the DDP Goldberg match because fuck that chicken.
Oof.
All right.
No, trust me, this wasn't the move I was going to make. I was going to make a switch, but since I have to use Peyton Royce, I officially can't use the switch. Yeah, so we're getting rid of DDP and Goldberg. And Matt, I want a ruling on this. I want to make Peyton Royce and Billy Kay versus Lay Cool.
Ooh.
Whoa. Retired, though, right?
So was DDP and Raven.
I would have used Trish and Lita, but Trish is pregnant.
Technically.
And Brie Bella is also pregnant, and Nikki's in a match race, so I can't do that either.
Should we go with the vote?
I don't see any reason why Vince McMahon couldn't back up the Brinks truck and convince Michelle McCool and was the other cool? Layla? Is it just Layla?
I don't know if you'd need a Brinks truck for Layla.
Anyone opposed to the using of Michelle McCool in Lay Cool for Mayhem Mania? Speak up. All right.
I don't allow it.
All right. Yes. Lay Cool versus the Iconic Duo. I love it.
It's a good match.
Peyton and Billy versus Lay Cool. Great. Now we got two women's matches on the card. We're making great progress. Let's see. Who did I say was next on this thing? Sorg, you're next.
Oh, I'm next.
Last minute change, Missy, you're after Sorg.
All right. What do we got here? Man, I really want... I really want to do something with that Gallagher thing. But then I'm going to have to sleep on the couch. and she could
well,
always.
Sorry, we've already established you're the worst husband. So...
Yeah, that is true. I am the worst husband.
Maybe you could make it
better. I can definitely make it better and appease my wife at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think I do. We do. Have we made a ruling on Finn Balor?
He's in.
He's booked in a house show. I'd say he's in.
And I can swap one for one. I can't really add more than that. Or I just kill a match and replace, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oof. What do I want there?
Or you could Bogart the subtract rule.
I don't want to Bogart a subtract. No, that's all important. He's pointing at it there.
Subtract rule. Hanging out next to
HBK and IWC 16. Man. I think I want to see... Oh, I'm gonna look. I'm getting this action over here. I can't even pull up the shot. Yeah, I'm getting that look right now. If you're on video,
choose your next words wisely.
I'm gonna swap Gotch for Finn.
There you go.
Let's make it happen.
Finn's gonna have to grow a mustache. Well, he has one, right?
He can draw one.
Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh!
He can draw one.
He did have facial hair last, when they showed.
He's got like a beard thing going on, doesn't he?
Everyone has a coming back from injury beard.
That's right. Yes. That's right. It's like a playoff beard.
It's a rite of passage.
Yeah, it's a rite
shaving
of passage.
Shaving's
overrated.
I keep losing. I just want to make sure. Okay, Missy, you're up. Garza, you're on deck. Know anybody with a mustache?
Missy, can you step out from behind the microphone?
Oh, sorry.
Sorry.
Yes. I'm going to take Samson out of that Styles Nakamura match.
You're going to use the subtract option?
I am.
Yay! All right. The subtract option's been cashed in, Sorg.
Oh, no. Wait,
show me.
Oh, no. Wait, show me. There it is.
Subtract option's been cashed in. Woo! That's a surprise.
You made it in the trash can.
Oh, you made it in the trash can.
Did I? Oh!
Wow. Flew right by her, too.
All right. Good job.
All righty.
Garza, you're up. Rizz, you are on deck.
All right,
go on. Sweet. All righty. I need a ruling on two guys. Booker T and Scott Steiner.
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
I gotta say, I think yes on both.
Yeah, really?
One's free agent and one's in WWE, so.
Yeah, I mean, they're out there. They're not, like, incapacitated or anything, are they? Yeah, they're all right.
One owns a Shoney's.
Okay, so
stipulations are later.
Yeah.
I'm gonna take that Nakamura versus AJ Styles match and get rid of it.
Oh.
Wow.
And this is a match that has been building up like for years. The midweek war. This is my TNA showcase match.
What is this?
Oh, no.
What is happening?
Where does Mayhem Mania come to?
Everyone quiet, man. Let him have the floor.
Let him have the floor.
Hey, to be fair, that match has a 33.3% chance to be a good match.
So, it's going to be Bobby Roode.
Oh, okay.
Former tag team partner, Austin Aries. And his other former tag team partner, Eric Young.
Oh, no.
Oh, wow.
Oh,
no.
Versus.
Oh, no. What are you doing, Garza?
The main event, Mafia.
Oh,
yes.
No.
Oh,
no.
Wow. Yes. And Kurt Angle.
Oh, my God. Fuck you.
You know what? It's right around this point that I would usually be saying, Garza's going to hate making this graphic, but he made the match. So.
Can you call them in a suit, Garza? Hold on, guys.
Can you restate the match? Because there's some crosstalk there, and I don't know if it got out there.
Restate, Garza.
Okay, so it's a team of Bobby Roode, Austin Aries, and Eric Young versus the main event Mafia, Scott Steiner, Booker T, and Kurt Freaking Angle.
Oh my God.
And the main event Mafia is always in suits. So
to be fair, also, when WWE buys the tape library of TNA, they'll own those footage.
That's true.
Wow. Rizz, you're up.
Hold on, does that mean that Missy gets the Alex Cars role?
Yes.
Okay. Ooh.
So
just when you think you're out, we drag you back in.
I have a question.
All right. Rizz, this is what you've been waiting for.
This is what I've been waiting for. I've been waiting, and actually this made it a lot easier.
Been waiting so long.
So we have one match that's one day away from retirement into the main card.
Yeah, we got some Danny Glover right now.
I'm deleting that.
Fuck you!
Which one?
You, Rizz!
All of it.
Which one?
I take back what you said. You should grow your facial hair again.
I wish that would have happened
which
earlier,
match?
Then I could have deleted who
which
I wanted
match?
To
which match? Which match? Let him talk.
The mixed tag match. That is gone.
Oh, no.
You son of a...
Oh, no.
Wow, okay.
I thought that was the other one.
That wasn't the one I thought you were doing.
No.
Okay.
No, the other one was okay.
I take back what I said. You look great, Riz.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That means a lot. So my question is, are we allowed to just put a match back in?
That was deleted earlier?
Yes.
Yeah, if they're not being used anywhere. If the
then Shinsuke Nakamura versus AJ Styles is back in.
All right.
Wow.
Wait, so does that rescind the Alex Kars rule?
I don't think, though.
It might.
Because it was Missy's.
You know what? We'll talk about that.
I changed it.
You know what? We'll talk about whether or not that rescinds the Alex Kars rule coming up on Talking Mayhem Mania, the hottest new show on the internet. Check your local listings, and that will
be on the
discussed.
It'll be on the YouTube and the Facebook.
Yes.
And you guys thought I was going to do a broken Matt Hardy mention, didn't you?
Yeah.
Definitely squandered this opportunity.
I was so scared of what you were going to do.
All right, let's run down the card real quick, Sorg. I don't want to keep everyone waiting. Here's what we've got after... Good job this week, guys.
Thank you.
AJ Styles versus Shinsuke Nakamura. The Shield versus The New Day. Jack Gallagher versus Finn Balor. Samoa Joe versus Braun Strowman. Strowman reigns. Bobby Roode, Austin Aries, and Eric Young versus Booker T, Scott Steiner, and Kurt Angle. Raven versus Bray Wyatt. Peyton Royce and Billy Kay versus Lay Cool. And Charlotte versus Asuka.
Asuka.
There it is. We have another graduated match.
Yes, we do!
I'll tell you what it is on Talking Mayhem Mania, the hottest damn new show on the internet. The one that's making Sorgatron Media shoot up to new heights, Sorg. I'm doing this for you. Lots on the agenda tonight. Can't wait to go through it in 10 minutes.
Fantastic. All right. Well, it's time to end up the night with the way that we usually do. It's time for what's happening.
What is it time for? There has been some response to some of the stuff that we've had, some of the discussion that we've had going on.
there's
a lot of commentary going on.
All right. Before we get there, so what's going on out there?
Well, Ed Burke was commenting about how they would write off the Hardys. And he says the same way they wrote off Bully Ray when the Dudleys came back to WWE, ignore it entirely. It's TNA tradition after all. Chad.
I gotta say, I love Chad's. Jokes on Orton for tonight, bringing down the on SmackDown. Bray had quite the insurance policy. When your dad was IRS, you learn a few things.
Yes.
Good point.
I love it.
Good point, Chad the Shad.
Dave Podner also responded to the how would you write off the Hardys, and he said one word: volcano.
Yes.
Oh, yes. I like that. I like that.
So, see, that this is why I had to make sure that those comments were brought into the conversation, because they were pretty freaking awesome.
Yep.
All right. So now,
what did you learn from wrestling this week, guys? And you guys in the chat room as well. Anybody?
I learned.
Hold on. Matt?
I learned Randy Orton is an arsonist.
He has so many skills.
He does have skills. And you know, not everyone could have pulled that off tonight on SmackDown.
Yeah.
Randy Orton
doesn't that
pull
just,
that off.
Doesn't that just make him Ralph Wiggum? Didn't the voices tell him to burn things too?
Yeah.
That was the leprechaun.
Maybe.
Leprechaun.
That's
he
true.
He could be
leprechaun.
Irish.
Told me to burn things.
Riz, what'd you learn?
I learned that with the degree that I have, that when somebody comes out with a crutch, you immediately know that they are using that wrong.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
For those of you who don't know, there has to be some space, I believe it's two fingers, between the crutch and the armpit.
Okay.
there was no space in between Seth Rollins and that crutch.
For somebody that went through rehab, you think he would know that, right?
You think, but it looks like they just handed him a crutch and just said, "Here, take this and go out there." But
not crutch.
That's what I learned.
Okay.
And also, Shikara is coming back with new episodes.
What about you, Mike?
I learned that Kid Rock should never be invited back to WrestleMania.
What did he do?
Why?
Just in general. I was just, like I said, I was just watching WrestleMania 25.
Oh, from experience.
Yeah, he gave a whole concert.
Yeah.
And I just put it on mute and I just watched something.
Was that the one where all the divas came out to dance with him or whatever?
Yeah, where it was all of the 25th anniversary of divas looking to crown the Miss WrestleMania, and then Santino wins. And we don't even get introductions of any of them.
No, Santina won. I mean,
Santina.
No, Santina won.
Yeah, same thing.
Right. No, people. That's different. That's different.
Same thing.
No, it's different.
Just because that year he identified as Santina doesn't mean it's the same person.
That was his sister.
Insert a joke about a bathroom here.
That whole Santino thing would play out completely different today than it did.
That is true too. It'd be a little more heavy.
A lot more alive.
Could I go?
Yes.
Sure, Bobby. You can go.
I learned that John Cena plays video games, and that was evidenced by his Switch commercial for Nintendo, and tonight on SmackDown, he summoned Nikki Bella like a Final Fantasy monster.
He did.
And she came out and she attacked Maryse. It was perfect. It was like, and then later on in the show, Dean Ambrose tried to summon Baron Corbin like a Final Fantasy monster, and it didn't work, so he didn't have enough MP.
Nikki Bella uses self-importance. It worked very well.
It's super effective.
It's super effective.
Also, Dana Brooke will interfere in any match eventually.
Yes, exactly.
Or incorrectly.
Also true.
Oh my God, Dana Brooke's going to interfere in Owen versus Goldberg.
Pretty much. Missy, slowly. What did you learn from wrestling this week? I need to turn your mic on. That's what I learned.
I learned that I really, really, really like every WWE show except for Raw.
Oof.
Yes, that's entirely accurate.
Yes, that's what I learned.
Wow.
Antonio Garza, I'm turning on your thing. I'm sorry.
Why are you yelling?
Because he's not facing.
Because I'm not
mic.
On the mic. There we go. Antonio Garza, I'm summoning you. Please.
Like a fantasy monster.
Yes, exactly.
I learned that amongst all the chaos, I believe in the love of Allie and Braxton Soder.
That was very heartwarming.
It was a rare
happy ending.
It was, yeah. Absolutely. Missy's clicking a lot angrily right now. And I learned that if you believe hard enough that your imaginary friend will become real, and then Samantha Heights will put a mark on her, on him. Yep. There's a new member of the Sexy Talented Dudes, so expect him to be joining us on the Christmas special this year. Big Billy.
That's going
to
be so weird.
Big Billy. And he is fascinating. he is interesting.
And Sorg, we have some things what people learn from the chat room.
I'm getting to those, Mike.
Okay,
but if you would like to read those, please do.
Sure. Billy Johnson learned that Cena is still the face that runs the place because his segment went over 20 minutes of a 2-hour show. Wheels learned that hashtags are. I wasn't complaining about that either. I thought that was a great segment.
That was a great segment. Yeah.
Wheels learned that hashtags are amazing, even though he can't spell hashtags. And Brandon learned that Maryse has one move called slap.
And it's super effective.
It's like in WWE No Mercy, where every woman wrestler had the face slap and then the mini slaps to the back of the head.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. Wasn't everyone's finisher the women's finishing slap?
Yes. Yeah. Wasn't Howard Finkel's the same?
Yes.
Okay. It was.
Someone did mention this on Twitter tonight, and I was having trouble with it. Does anyone remember any other move that Maryse did while she was wrestling? Like, does anyone know what her finisher was?
Yeah.
What the hell was it?
It was a split leg. It was a split leg drop thing.
Yeah.
Wow.
Wait, it was like
she was good. I remember
she was good, but I don't remember any of the moves.
Yeah.
She also didn't she do a? Wasn't she the first person to do a selfie in wrestling, like during a match?
I don't know.
Probably.
I thought
I remember that. Like at the end of the match, she took out her phone and took a picture of her on top of somebody.
Yes, because she did the lean back pin thing.
That sounded
She did the lean back pin. She took a selfie on her vanquished opponent.
Well, guys, thank you very much for joining us. Antonio Garza, thank you for returning to the show. Is there anything going on with you and want to plug?
No, not much. Just go to TheWrestlingRevolution.com. We review every freaking show out there, like literally. So if you're looking for an opinion, it's probably wrong, but you have it.
You want opinions? We got them. WrestlingRevolution.com.
Tons of them.
Mad Mike, he's got his opinions, and he does them on the Midweek War and the Raw Wrap Up with me, where we play a game with Impact Wrestling, which is which of these three things actually happened or did not happen on Impact Wrestling.
Sorg, that game this week might be who's still employed by TNA Wrestling.
Who on this week's show is actually going to be here in 2 weeks?
If anyone wants like positive opinions on TNA, I do have some.
You have some opinions.
I am the only person on the internet with positive opinions on TNA.
Hey, if TNA does things I like, I say positive things.
There was. No, he does from time to time. He actually does, you know, so there's that. The positive thing is our show. Bobby FJ Town, of course, Bobby FJ Town on the Twitter. What are you doing, Bobby?
Stuff.
He's on Panel Riot last week talking about his Funko Pop addiction.
So if you didn't know about Funko Pops, that's your show.
Bobby, I think you have a problem.
It wasn't an intervention. It was a celebration. of my being in debt.
Hashtag
Kickstarter.
Hashtag Funko Pop House.
That's how we build the wall.
Yeah. One day I'm just going to be buried under them all.
Somebody help him. It's all the plastic and cardboard. Mainstream Matt on the Twitters.
Hi, everybody. I found the French kiss was like a DDT thing.
Did a split when she brought him down.
I found one of the WWE 30-second Fury super clips of nothing but French kiss DDTs. I'll tweet it out at Mainstream Matt with one T, and you can judge for yourself if she does a split, because all I see is a DDT.
All right.
To Mainstream Matt.
She did like a course. Final cut type.
Yeah.
Sorg, I forgot. 32 Manias with Mike coming this Thursday.
Check it out.
This Thursday.
And of course, the Rizz.
Hi, Sorg. I'm doing things.
Oh, he's doing things.
I'm doing things very, 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 very soon because I was just testing it out.
There you go. New hardware.
Follow Rizz Plays Games.
New
on
improved Rizz Plays Games. And
I might hold a Twitch. I might hold a Switch soon enough.
And at Wife of the Show for producer Missy and let her know how to give her some critique on how she keeps things organized here on the Mayhem Show and keeps
Missy,
us reined in.
That Sorg.
Yeah, of course. Yes, I don't know. Or plug podcampittsburgh.com.
Yeah, podcampittsburgh.com is a good thing to plug.
There you go.
Yeah, so got a lot of fun stuff going on there.
There you go. And of course, SorgatronMedia.com, MikeSorg.com for everything that I have got going on. And check out the rest of the shows. And stay tuned at Mayhem Show on the Twitter. Join us live.wrestlingmayhemshow.com every Tuesday at 10 p.m. Eastern until whenever we damn well please. So you can it's drop strange, in like sorry. Our good friends like Billy, Tina, Hot Wheels, Brandon, John, Jason, and so many other ones. Hashtag Hooven Ground. We'll see you guys next week. Mayhem out. Just wait. Mayhem Show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.